John Setka has defied calls to stand down from the CFMEU, despite pressure from both sides of politics. The controversial union boss and his wife today blasted critics for using their marriage troubles in a politically motivated campaign. Kari-Anne Greenbank with the details.
Facing the media hand in hand, a defiant John Setka and wife Emma Walters.
Why should I step down?
Refusing to resign, the union heavyweight is denying reports he denigrated Rosie Batty in a union speech, saying her advocacy against family violence had eroded men's rights.
There was no denigration of Rosie Batty whatsoever. And whoever says that should be ashamed of themselves, because they were there and they know I never said that.
Emma Walters called the years of controversy surrounding her husband a Get John Setka campaign.
My family has been dragged through the mud and we're simply asking for privacy to heal our marriage, protect our children, just as any parent would want to do.
The headline started in 2015 when Mr. Setka faced court accused of blackmailing GrowCon's concrete supplier. Those charges were eventually dropped.
It was definitely a witch hunt.
In 2017, he threatened to reveal home addresses of inspectors working for the Australian Building and Construction Commission.
Their kids will be ashamed of who their parents are.
A year later, he tweeted an image of his children with a message for the commission's boss before being hit with charges for allegedly harassing a woman using a carriage service, for which he's indicated he will plead guilty. Now the reported comments about Rosie Batty denounced by both sides of politics, although the Premier today stopped short of calling for his job.
Ultimately, his position at the union is a matter for members of that union.
If Daniel Andrews has the courage of his convictions, if he really wants to get rid of John Setka, then he needs to say, I won't take a single dollar from the CFMEU until Setka goes.
The CFMEU chief can only be removed by the majority of his colleagues.
While John Setka maintains he won't resign unless he loses the support of his members, Anthony Albanese is making sure he will be expelled from the Labor Party when the National Executive meets next month.
The union secretary has already been sacked from a government advisory board.
I'm simply asking the people who are using our private lives to wage a political war against my husband John to stop.
Kari-Anne Greenbank, Nine News.